Answer. Tricky's condition made Mrs. Pamprey call the vet for help. Tricky had grown fat and lazy. He just used to lie on his rug and pant. He also refused to eat food, even his favorite dishes. His bouts of vomiting added to Mrs. Pamprey's worry. That is why she called James Herriot. Question number 10. What kind of treatment was given to Tricky? Did it help it in his recovery? Answer. Tricky was given a non-medicinal treatment. His diet regime was altered depending upon his body's response to it. He was kept on liquid diet for the first 2 days and then his diet was gradually increased. Yes, this treatment did help Tricky as it built up energy in him. He was transformed to an energetic, hard-muscled dog in just a fortnight. My dear students, these are all the sample answers. I am not saying that these are the fixed answers, but these are the sample answers and you are supposed to write in your own words. You can take help from my notes, but I request to write your answers in your own words. Take help from my notes, right? Next question. Was Tricky suffering from any ailment in reality? If not, then what made him inactive and lethargic? Answer. No, Tricky was not suffering from any ailment. It was his greed for food and the love of his mistress that spoiled his health to such an extent. He was being overfed every day and that made him obese and lethargic. That is why his health showed rapid improvement when his diet was controlled. Question number 12. Do you think Tricky was enjoying his stay at the hospital? Yes, Tricky was definitely enjoying his stay at the hospital. He had befriended the gang of shabby household dogs. He had found a new joy in being bowled over, trampled on and squashed. He had also grown very energetic. He used to play and run all day long with the dogs. He was having a good time. Question number 13. Why is he tempted to keep Tricky on as a permanent guest? Answer. Mr. Herriot is tempted to keep Tricky on as a permanent guest because of the good food and wine he is enjoying in Tricky's name. He does not want to lose the luxurious inflow of fresh eggs, wine and brandy. Question number 14. Why does Mrs. Pamprey think the dog's recovery is a triumph of surgery? Answer. Mrs. Pamprey thinks that Tricky's recovery is a triumph of surgery because his illness was very serious. She was of the opinion that there were very few chances of Tricky to improve and he needed immediate medical attention. Thus, his revival without any medicinal treatment was a great achievement, according to her. Question number 15. Do you think Tricky was happy to go home? What do you think will happen now? Answer. Tricky was happy to go back home as he really loved his mistress and the comfort of his lavish life. He didn't have any friends at home, like in the hospital, but he seemed equally excited at the sight of Mrs. Pamprey. I think that Mrs. Pamprey will be careful onwards about Tricky's diet and health. She may also give him exercise daily as prescribed by the vet earlier. Question number 16. Do you think it is a real life episode or mere fiction, or is it a mixture of both? Answer. The story seems to be a mixture of both. It may be possible for each person to overfed their pets out of love. It is not unusual for them to maintain a vast wardrobe for them either. But it is unlikely for a veterinary doctor to go out of the way and lie in order to save an animal. It is also unusual for anyone to consume food which is given in the name of a pet's health. Question number 17. This episode describes the silly behavior of a rich woman who is foolishly indulgent, perhaps because she's lonely. Do you think such people are merely silly or can their actions cause harm to others? Answer. Mrs. Pamprey's actions had a harmful reaction on Tricky's health. She was over-pampering and overfeeding Tricky in the name of love. This worsened his condition to an extent that he had to be hospitalized. People like Mrs. Pamprey are not just merely silly, but their actions can definitely have dangerous consequences for others. So, my dear students, there are so many questions that can be generated from this chapter, like pen down incidences in support of values one should inculcate from Mr. James Herriot. Or Do you think parents like Mrs. Pamprey exist? If yes, is it a good thing to pamper children? Why or why not? Or what would you have done if you were A. A member of the staff in Mrs. Pamprey's household? B. A neighbor? What would your life have been like in general? One question might be, what kind of a person do you think the narrator, a veterinary surgeon, is? Would you say he is tactful as well as full of common sense? Right? My dear students, as I have already told you that these are all just sample answers. You are supposed to write your own answer in your own words. You should take help from the notes that I have given in this audio. And again, I request to make posters relevant to the topic that I dispatched. Right? Thank you.